A very warm welcome and a good evening to yet another exciting and informative episode of our technology show, Innovate. Here we bring you all you would want to know from the world of technology and innovations with me, Brenda Kembabazi. But first, a sneak peek of what we have for you this evening. And for this week on Innovate, it is the light transmission system that allows devices to transmit data at high speed. And also, the public taxi application that just might be the solution to the insecurity and inconvenience on public taxis.
Every day that passes by, technology keeps getting better, given the young minds that spend sleepless nights just to make everything that we use much better and, of course, simpler. Now, Horace Mwaka, a student at the International University of East Africa, created the light transmission system that allows technology and communication between devices using light at terrific speeds. We show you now how it works.
The light transmission is a brainchild of Horace Mwaka. It is a technology for wireless communication between devices using light to transmit data in a high speed.
Light data transmission system is a system designed and you can use it to transmit data via using light waves. You can use it to transmit video or video pictures, you can use it to transmit sound, you can use it to transmit internet data, it can do wireless internet like Wi-Fi, but yeah, you're using light instead of radio waves.
Horace has been at this innovation for a while now, through a series of tests and research to where it is.
I worked on it for 3 weeks from 5th of October to around 30th of October. I started to work on it, but for 2 weeks it was not working. But I was still trying. Then, like on the third week, it worked. And at first I didn't know whether it can transmit internet or video, but I tried it with sound and it was successful. But later when I did more research, I discovered sound, light can also be used to transmit video and internet network.
In its present state, only LED lamps can be used for the transmission of visible light. The key technical difference is that Wi-Fi uses radio frequency to transmit data.
It is like the one which works as a transmitter is a light emitting diode. It is the one that transmits light containing whatever you're transmitting, like a sound, video, or internet network. Then that is part of transmission. There's the battery, then there is light emitting diode. Then for receiver, there is a solar panel. A solar panel helps to convert that. A transmitter converts light waves, converts sound or internet into light. Then the solar panel that receives converts that light back to sound. Then it is amplified via two amplifiers, low signal amplifier, light signal amplifier, then it goes to the speaker. Also, when it comes to video, it is amplified the same way as sound. And for the case of internet network, the signals have to also be amplified because they are always low when they are received by the solar panel. So the solar panel is the one that converts from light then to back to what you transmitted.
It's a little like Wi-Fi, but has reached speeds 100 times faster in testing, making it far more suited for the demands of the future for data. But the advantages are not only in speed. It is estimated that in the near future, we will be able to transmit data through solar energy, which will facilitate access to people without internet and with limited electricity resources.
One, it is secure when it comes to security. Unlike when you're transmitting internet data, unlike Wi-Fi, where it goes anywhere and anyone can access that network and can hack into, even if it has password, can hack and break the password and use it. For this, when you're using light, you can limit where the network has to reach by blocking the light. So it is easy if you have it in your house, you can use the lights in your house to give you light, at the same time give you internet network. There you'll be saving the money to buy internet router and saving even the power consumed by the internet router. Then when it comes to health, when you're exposed much to radio waves, like this one of Wi-Fi, they can cause like a brain cancer. But for when you're using light, you can use lights in your room to give you internet. It is very safe, doesn't cause any disease.
Using light to transmit data allows Li-Fi to offer several advantages, like working across higher bandwidth, working in areas susceptible to electromagnetic interference, and offering higher transmission speeds.
I'm looking at like in the city, providing like wireless internet in the city, they can use these street lights to work as internet routers. So whenever you're like moving along the street at night, you can easily access wireless internet, and it is always so fast, because in the city people are many, they can easily use it, and it is not slow, there is no like because it is fast. And also I'm looking at since it uses light, like when you're like vehicles, you have cars, like when you're in jam, you can communicate via those lights, the front and back lights. You can use them to communicate together. When someone is not, can be listening to you, you can communicate and say, do like this, do this, via using those lights.
The technology is actively being developed for anybody that uses data, especially in public places like work, hospitals and institutions.
It is like mostly I'm targeting the places with very many people, like universities, schools, and also cities, like because this can support a large number of people and it is faster. So I'm targeting places where I find very many people using internet. Even other people can use it. You can use it at home. You use your lights in the house to provide you internet. But I'm most interested in schools, universities, and public places.
This is how this system works.
So this one is the transmission part, the one that transmits data or signals. It is composed, it has a torch, there's a battery connected also. So the battery is the one that makes this one to light. Then there's a pin, a jack for headset. Then when this one is the receiver, it has a solar panel that converts light back to the signal that was transmitted, whether sound or video or internet network. Then this one is the amplifier, a low signal amplifier, is the one that amplifies that signal to a higher voltage to make it be able to be amplified by the large signal amplifier. This one is the large signal amplifier. Then this one is the speaker, and also this one is the speaker. Then this one is the battery for powering this amplifier. Then this one is the transformer It's the one that steps down the power for powering the RAG signal amplifier. So you see, when I broke the light, can't get the sound. Even if you put an object, here, that because it can be transmitted because light passes through water. When you put this, it can only reduce the like the intensity because some of the light is refracted. But if I put something, that is opaque, you can't get the sound because the light cannot pass. So this is how you can be able to control where you have to be accessing the network when you're using it as internet route.
Li-Fi technology, the transmission of data via light, could now offer a safer alternative if expounded on from just a prototype to a working technology.
Innova takes a very short break, but we return with an innovation from the transport sector.